Well, talofa lover and hello. Sam Lotu-Iiga here again and here in Parliament and for my second update. And yeah, it's been, since the last update, it's been a sort of tough couple of months. We've had the tsunami in Samoa and quite a lot of damage to property, but the loss of life was quite huge in Samoa. 200 people were killed. Samoa and Tonga and American Samoa, and I went up there with the Prime Minister and the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Murray McCully, and we assessed the damage, we talked to the locals, and we worked with government officials to see the different ways that our government and the people of New Zealand could help. And it was quite sad for me personally, having been born in Samoa, to visit the damage, but what was really comforting was the people, were the people responding really well. They're quite resilient. They were getting on with their lives, rebuilding their lives, and burying their dead. But it was quite tough for me to see the damage and just how awful the consequences were for a number of families across Samoa. But the government responded well. We've obviously put a lot of money into supporting the New Zealand, the Samoan people and the Tongan people, and that's through resources, through money, and a whole range of other ways that New Zealanders can help. We've also been part of the fundraising effort back home here in New Zealand, and a number of charities, through concerts, through sports matches, and a number of different ways. The outpouring of love has been just great. And you know, we've seen New Zealanders respond in really positive ways. Been doing a bit of work around the electorate, and one of the things that I'm focusing on is early childhood education. So I've visited over 20 early childhood centres, seen the way that they operate, that they teach kids to play, also around numeracy and literacy, and talking to the parents as well as the teachers about what the issues are in early childhood education. And I think, you know, if there's one thing that our government can do to promote the interests of New Zealanders, it's certainly to ensure that every child has an education prior to going to school. And that's going to be really important going forward for this government. The other things that I've noticed in my work around the electorate has been the state of housing. I visit a number of state homes, talking to elderly folk, talking to disabled folk and people that are supported by social housing provided by the government. One of the things you notice that a lot of the houses are damp, a lot of the houses need repairing, and the insulation program that our government are running throughout New Zealand, we were looking at over 180,000 homes being insulated over the next 4 years. I think this is a great goal, and it will be a remarkable achievement if we can warm up homes, keep them dry, and so that families can enjoy their homes and get on with their lives. So two things that I think are really important going forward. Coming up, we've got urgency this week here in Parliament. And the ETS bill will be going through, and you know, it's a really busy time for us. Of course, in December and November, we go to a lot of school prize givings, and I've been to a number in my electorate, all the high schools, Onehunga High, One Tree Hill College, and what's astounded me is the level of talent that we've got in our schools, the gifts and the amazing abilities of some of our young people. And while much of the news is about some of the negative things that the youth provide our society and our communities, prize givings are a real good opportunity to see real talent and rewarding excellence in school, excellence in music and culture and art, and particularly excellence in academia. So it's been a real privilege for me to attend these services and these prize givings across my electorate. And coming up to Christmas, I just want to wish you and your families a Merry Christmas, peaceful New Year. 2010 is going to be a big year, not just here politically, but across this country as we move out of the recession. And I'm sure that you know, our government will be doing its best to providing the type of social services and the economic framework to push our country ahead into 2010 and beyond. So I wish you well. Merry Christmas.